Hey man, you see my bag in here?
No, I ain't seen it.
Alright, it's probably my locker.
Where were we?
I'm not going to tell her. If she wants to go ahead and file, that's up to her.
Divorce is a hard thing, man.
Well, if it brings peace.
But Caleb, you want the right kind of peace.
What do you mean by that?
Do you know what that ring on your finger means?
It means I'm married.
Yeah, well, it also means you made a lifelong covenant. You putting on that ring while saying your vows. The sad part about it is, when most people promise for better or for worse, they really only mean for the better.
Catherine and I were in love when we got married, but today, we're two very different people, all right? It's just not working out anymore.
Caleb, salt and pepper are completely different. Their makeup is different, their taste and their color. But you always see them together. And when you... Hold on just a second.
What are you doing? Michael. Hey. What'd you do that for?
Caleb, when two people get married, it's for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health.
I know that. But marriages aren't fireproof. Sometimes you get burned.
Fireproof doesn't mean that a fire will never come, but that when it comes, you'll be able to withstand it.
You didn't have to glue them together.
Don't do it, Caleb. If you pull them apart now, you'll break either one or both of them.
I am not a perfect person, but better than most. And if my marriage is failing, it is not all my fault.
But Caleb, man, I've seen you run into a burning building to save people you don't even know. But you're gonna let your own marriage just burn to the ground.
Michael, you are my friend, and I've allowed you to speak freely with me on this job. Don't abuse it.
My son, this 40-day journey cannot be taken lightly. It is a challenging and often difficult process, but an incredibly fulfilling one. If you will commit to a day at a time for 40 days, the results could change your life and your marriage. Consider it a dare from others who have done it before you. Day 1. The first part of this dare is fairly simple. Although love is communicated in a number of ways, our words often reflect the condition of our heart. For the next day, resolve to say nothing negative to your spouse at all. If the temptation arises, choose not to say anything. It's better to hold your tongue than to say something you'll regret. Be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to get angry. James 1:19.
Did you have time to take that to the dry cleaners today?
I think after 2 days off, you would have already taken care of that.
Day two. It is difficult to demonstrate love when you feel little to no motivation. But love, in its truest sense, is not based on feelings, but a determination to show thoughtful actions, even when there seems to be no reward. In addition to saying nothing negative to your spouse today, do at least one unexpected gesture as an act of kindness.
Poured your coffee.
I don't have time for coffee.
Day three. Whatever you put your time, energy, and money into will become more important to you. It's hard to care for something you're not investing in. Along with refraining from any negative comments, buy your wife something that says you were thinking of her today.
Yeah, I need to order some flowers or something for my wife. No, it doesn't matter. Sure. How much does that cost? 45. Do you have something cheaper? Yeah. Yeah, that's more like it. Let's go with the 25. How about a box of chocolates or something? How much is that? Oh, you're killing me. That's better. Okay, how about a little stuffed bear? All right, forget the bear. Okay, how long is it going to take you to throw something like that together?
Terrell, I can bench 300 right now.
For real?
Why can't we all come to the same obvious conclusion that I am the man?
All I know is the man left the thermal imaging device on the bumper of the truck last night. Mm-hmm. That's an $8,000 piece of equipment, Wayne.
All right, my bad, Captain. But that still doesn't change the fact when it comes to difficult situations, I can take it.
Man, I can't take this much ego. Wayne, you've been bragging on yourself for 10 minutes, man.
It ain't bragging if it's true. Last week at the apartment fire, I pulled off two attack lines, laid my own supply line, and called a hydrant in under 2 minutes.
So? There's other folks that could do that, man.
Not from this station.
Tom McBride could.
And Station 4? Are you kidding? He might could do it in 2.5, but he can't do it under 2.
I don't know.
Captain, he's strong, but he's not as fast. I could take him any day of the week.
You know, Wayne, you seem pretty high on yourself. I think confidence is a good thing, but you're over the top.
Man, he way over the top.
I can back it up. That's all I'm saying.
Wrath of God, baby.
What's that for? We're about to have a little contest. We're just going to see if Wayne really is the man. That is, if he's up to the challenge.
Oh, I'm all about this.
All right. I'll go first.
What are you going to do?
Michael, time me.
You got it. Ready? Go.
No way.
Man, you crazy. He gonna drink the whole thing.
Dude. 23 seconds.
All right, man. You're up.
All right. That was impressive. Till I do it under 20. Time me.
Oh, I time you. Ready?
Ladies.
Go.
Oh, Wayne.
It's hot.
Go, Wayne.
Maybe, Wayne.
I thought you could take it. You gotta drink that, bro.
14 seconds, Wayne.
Come on.